Now tell me, if the net torque is zero, if the net torque is zero, will the object ever translate?
Yes, it will translate.
No, it is. It can translate.
It can translate. Okay, example.
So if I have something and I push it from both sides, if I have a rigid body and I push it from both sides.
Okay, one second. Now tell me, suppose there is one rod like that, you're pushing from, like what Param is saying, suppose I'm push it from both sides with F. What will be the acceleration of center of mass?
Two F
is the net force on this system. 2F is equal to M into ACM. So ACM will be 2F by M. Simple. Got it? Now, what about the torque about this point, about this center? How much is the torque?
It will be zero.
Why?
Because both of the forces
both are acting in the same direction.
This force creates a rotating torque in this way,
and so
that creates in opposite way. So their rotating effect get cancelled away. So net torque is zero. Okay. So just because the net torque is zero doesn't mean that net force is zero. Getting it?
So in this case, what's perpendicular distance for like
east? Perpendicular distance from here into drop of perpendicular on this line of force. So this is the perpendicular distance itself. It is already perpendicular. Okay. Clear? Now what if net force is zero? Can the object or rigid body rotate?
No. No, it can. So I can flip that force to that side.
Yeah.
Then it will get a net torque, but net force is zero.
Yeah. I hope you understood what he's saying.
Yeah.
Okay, so suppose you have a rod like this, one force from top like this, one force from below. Equal and opposite force? Will this object rotate?
Yes.
It will rotate. When you open the cap, there also you apply equal and opposite force. You don't want center of the cap to move. So acceleration of center of mass is?
Zero.
Center of mass is not moving, but entire object is rotating. Fine, so there is some rotation or there is an angular acceleration. Force causes acceleration, torque causes angular acceleration. Please write it down. Cause of acceleration is force, cause of angular acceleration is torque. If net torque is zero, angular acceleration will be zero. If net torque is zero, angular acceleration will be zero. Is there any doubt?
So sir, even if net torque is zero, it can be rotating with uniform angular velocity.
Yes. If the net torque is zero, the angular velocity is either zero or uniform. Because angular acceleration is zero, right? Omega can still be there, constant omega. Just like if force is not zero, sorry, if force is zero, there can be constant velocity. So apni kya lega tha? If net torque is zero, the angular acceleration is zero. Alright? So if point is in equilibrium, let's say a particle is in equilibrium, what we say? Net force is
zero.
Okay? That is basically giving you translational equilibrium. If net force is zero, ACM is zero. Translation won't happen. But can rotation be still happening? Is it possible? Yes, we have just seen. It is still possible to have rotation. Are you getting it? So, in order to have a rigid body in equilibrium, not only net force should be zero, but also net torque also should be zero. Then only it will not have acceleration of center of mass, nor it will have angular acceleration. Are you getting it? So, if angular acceleration of center of mass is alpha, what will be the angular acceleration of the tip of the circle?
Alpha.
Alpha only. Okay, it's a rigid body, so alpha of all the points will be same. Okay, now there are I mean, just one type. There is one special type of torque. Usually what happens, torque depends on the distance about which you are finding the torque. Okay, suppose I am trying to find out a torque of the force which is 2 km away from this point. It will be very large compared to the torque of this force which is nearby force from me. Okay, now there is this special scenario of two equal and opposite forces which we have drawn actually. These form couple, so they are called couple. They are special kind of torque. I'm not exactly sure spelling is this only, but let's keep it like that. So this is the rod. Two equal and opposite forces are applied on it. Total length is L. Okay, total length of this three colors I have. Total length is L. Okay, you need to find the torque about the center of mass. First, find out how much is the torque about the center.
FN by 2.
Bolo? Properly do it.
About the total torque, right? Yes,
no, FL. About the center, it will just be FL.
Yeah. FL.
About the center.
Yeah, total torque will be FL. Both
about the center. About the center.
No. Wait.
Is it just FL?
No.
FL.
No.
Center.
So
is it
FL?
FL.
Zero. It is FL.
Yeah, it's just FL.
Wait, so, but the center is not rotating.
About the center, I am finding the torque. Perpendicular distance of the center from this force is what? Kitna hai? What? L by 2. Torque because of this force about this point is how much? F into L by 2. Which way? Like this. About that, for that force about this point is? FL by 2, which direction?
Same.
Like this. Right? So they will add or subtract. Add. Total couple is FL by 2 plus FL by 2, which is F into L.
Sir, but when we
think of the top by the negative, it is up to you. It's up to you, like I said, one direction you can assume positive, one negative. But usually what we do is that, clockwise we take negative. So it will actually speaking, it should be minus FL. Okay? But you can also say that this direction taking positive, or you can write FL clockwise, like that you can write. Okay? Guys, keep quiet. Find out torque about this point, which is at a distance of x from here.
So FL.
Sure?
Yeah.
Just because you know the final answer.
Torque
because of this force is what?
Fx.
About that?
Fx.
This comes out to be F into L. Okay, now find out the torque about kiska alarm baj raha bhai? About this point P. kiska phone hai? Whose alarm? Kitne alarm lagaya tune? Find out torque about P.
It's going to be FL except this time anti-clockwise.
Properly do it. Properly do it. No nonsense approach.
Yeah, it's positive.
It can't be anything other than the same.
It's negative. Yeah, it's the same.
What is the torque because of this force about this point?
minus Fx.
It will be F into L this way. Sorry, F into X. Okay, so F into X like this. What about that force? Torque is F L plus X, but in which direction?
Clockwise.
It will be like this. So these two are in opposite direction, sense of rotation about this point. So till now this force was causing like that sense of rotation, but that was any axis that side. About this axis it causes the rotation this way. So that is why this become in opposite, this is now in opposite direction of that. So you need to subtract this from that, you get FL only, right? So you can take any point, about any point, you can take here also, anywhere. The torque will be F into L only. So a couple, if net force is zero, will have the same torque about any axis, anything.
So is this free for any body?
Yeah, why not? Okay.
Couple is always at opposite ends.
A couple is?
Always at opposite
ends. Net force should be zero. The definition of couple is two equal and opposite forces. Okay. Any other doubt? Okay, so please write down condition. Center of mass acceleration should be zero. It should not translate with any acceleration, neither it should rotate with any angular acceleration. Simple conditions, right? So basically net force along x axis zero, along y axis should be zero, z zero, and torque about which? Torque about which axis should be zero? Torque about any axis. Torque about any axis should be zero. Fine? Any axis you take. Right? Now, going forward, we are going to study dynamics of the rotational this thing. In fact, moment of inertia was a part of rotational dynamics only. Here, we need to be very careful with where the force is applied. Alright, what is its distance from whatever axis you are considering or whatever point you are considering, and what is the angle it is making with the distance. So when you draw the free body diagram for rigid body, you can't just casually draw it with an arrow passing through whichever point you want as long as direction is fine. You need to not only take care of the direction, but also take care of about which point it is applied and how it is applied. Because you need to find torque. Torque is perpendicular distance into force. Okay? So going forward, free body diagram becomes a little bit more involved. Okay? And one more thing, when you write net force zero, all the forces will feature in the equation. All the forces will be there. But when you write net torque to be zero, torque about a particular force will become zero if you are finding about a point through which that force is applied. Are you getting it what I am trying to say? See, suppose this is the this is the thing I am solving right now, F1, F2, and this is fulcrum. Suppose I am finding torque about this point and equating it to zero. The normal reaction from here will not come in the equation, yes or no? Because torque due to normal reaction is zero. Perpendicular distance of normal reaction is zero. So it will not come in the torque equation. Fine? And how many torque equation you can have? Infinitely many. Right? Wherever you want to write the torque equation. So you can make your life simple by choosing an appropriate point about which you equate net torque to be zero. The variable itself, suppose there are three variables, two variables are not coming in the torque equation itself. only one variable is coming. So you can directly get the answer of that variable by writing the torque equation. Are you understand? Okay. So net force equal to zero, there is no brainer. You just write it down. When you write torque equal to zero, appropriately choose about which point you are writing the torque equal to zero. And you can write it about any point. Answer will not change. But the amount of time you take will change.